بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My brothers, my sisters, sometimes we have certain people in our lives who cause us problems because they're being sarcastic. They might be friends, they might be family, especially if it's people who are close to you in the community, and they start to become sarcastic. You know, some people, they just want to intimidate others in a crowd. They always like to, you know, have the banter and put someone down and make you feel a bit awkward because they're getting, you know, brownie points for it. Everyone's laughing. Wow. You know, they're the clever one, the intelligent one, the witty one. People give them credit and so on. And everyone laughs, and it's at your expense and you don't like it. Well, you know what? I have to say to you, the first thing is, it's not good to keep those people around you. I've come across this as well, and I've found some people just want to do that. It's just become the second nature, the habit, to always pick on others, to always, you know, sometimes it's about picking on others, and sometimes it's about just to prove that they are above others, they have to, you know, put others down. These are people who are arrogant, they've got a serious ego problem. And you need to first understand you don't need to be in their company because the way that you're feeling. Number two is that if you can advise them in any way privately, then please advise them. It's not always, you know, easy for these people to digest what you're going to say seriously. They will throw back at you. They'll come after you. They will attack you further if you ever gave them advice sometimes. I mean, if it's that level and you haven't got the experience to tell them privately or you don't feel comfortable, just leave it. However, being in the company of such people for a long time, sometimes it even affects you in the way that you want to do to others. And sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes you just feel bad about being in their company. You know what? My question is, why do you have to be in their company? Why? Why can't you just leave their company? Why can't you find other people? And this is my point about this reminder, which is surround yourself with people that you get on with, that are positive, and that are the people you want to have an effect on your life in the right way. Just surround yourself with those people. I've done that over a number of years. I don't have friends or close ones that will cause, you know, do something that is inappropriate. Or maybe sometimes they do something which you feel that, why on earth, you know, this is un-Islamic for this person to do this. Sometimes you have that in your mind, and if you carry on staying in that company, one day or another, they will do something that you will seriously be irritated by. Or they might even, you know, fail you in your own, you know, in your own little domain of where you are. They might fail you, they might backstab you, they might do something that's horrible to you. And it's happened to me as well. I want to be very honest with you. It's happened to me as well a number of times. For the last good few years, I've surrounded myself with people that I can get on with, people that are positive, people that are helpful, people that are just normal. Even if they're not helpful, it doesn't matter. But at least they're not the sarcastic type, they're not the intimidating type, they're not the arrogant type, they're not the people that break the Islamic adabs and etiquettes again and again in your presence. I mean, if they do that, I'll tell them nicely, but if they can't get a hold of themselves and chain themselves, then goodbye, assalamu alaikum. I mean, what does the Quran say? It says, وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمْ جَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. When the people who are ignorant of certain etiquettes and certain ways of being respectful, if they actually address you, peace, salam. You don't have to fight them. Just choose other people that will be around you. Try and rectify the problem, yes. But if they don't want to rectify themselves, then salam, peace. I go my peaceful way, bro. You go your peaceful way. We both live happily ever after. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
The Safar curriculum covers all the Islamic educational needs of young Muslims today in a fun, simple and engaging way. Tried and tested for over 15 years at one of the UK's leading maktabs, the curriculum has been adopted by hundreds of institutions around the world and makes your child's journey in seeking knowledge easy, meaningful and dynamic. This innovative and comprehensive curriculum covers Quran and Tajweed, Islamic studies, du'as and surahs, as well as Arabic in an integrated and structured way. Visit safarpublications.org to find out more.